We have reached that point, people. We're done. All the armchair know-it-alls, the barbershop coaches, the social media supermen who have spent the season taking shots at the Golden State Warriors, complaining today's NBA isn't physical as it used to be. It's over. Last night, the Warriors not only beat the Spurs, they beat the Spurs on the road, on the second night of a back-to-back, on the night when Pop played his best matchups. They have won 72 games. They have 73 in their sights. Enough! And this goes for all the former players, too. The haterade has been so strong from the old school that we have had to have a regular segment on this show called Get Off My Lawn. And it's a crowded lawn! Just take a look at that thing! Oscar Robertson, Walt Frazier, Scottie Pippen, on and on and on. And let's be clear, I have no problem with any of these guys thinking their team could beat these Warriors. If you're a great athlete, you're supposed to be internally competitive. You're supposed to think, I could take that guy. That's all good. But when Oscar Robertson says the only reason Steph Curry is succeeding is because modern NBA coaches don't understand defense, that's not competitive. That's disrespectful to the tens of thousands of hours Curry has worked on his game. When Scottie and Horace Grant say that in a seven-game series, the Bulls would sweep, that's not competitive. That's saying the Warriors have such little worth as a basketball team, it wouldn't even be a fight. And that's just not true. Yes, Golden State has won its 72 games under different conditions than the Bulls played under. But today's conditions aren't just de facto easier. The 96 Bulls didn't have to deal with the constant pressure and scrutiny this Warriors team is under. The Bulls weren't all, those games weren't all available to the whole country on TV. There was no social media. There were no cell phone cameras everywhere, giving these players absolutely no breathing room, even in their off time. Today's Warriors play in a league that draws from a much bigger global talent pool than the NBA of the 90s. And don't forget the motivation factor. So many basketball historians credit the Bulls' 72 wins to Michael Jordan, fresh off his baseball sabbatical, being hell-bent on proving any titles won in his absence were mere placeholders. Well, the Warriors are coming off a championship, which, as we've seen from the NBA to the NFL, can create a hangover a lot of teams really don't recover from. Oh, and Golden State didn't have his head coach for half the season. You know, Steve Kerr, who's won 6 championship rings. If you don't think that's a big deal to overcome, then you can't argue that Phil Jackson had any impact on the Bulls. And look, I am not saying any of this to discount the Bulls. I covered those 90s Bulls teams when I was a college student in Chicago. They were incredible, legendary. And to those Bulls' credit, over the past 24 hours, we have finally started to see some tweets, at least congratulating Golden State. Hey, maybe this is them slowly starting to see the error of their ways here. After all, it's a big lawn out there. It is officially time to give the Warriors their own corner of it.